Coming up on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, Sean Locke, John Richardson, Rosie Jones, Tom Allen, Sean Bean, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jimmy Cobb.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, show about letters, numbers and conundrums. OK, let's meet our players. First up is team captain Sean Locke. Some people are scared of Sean, but he's actually like a kitten. A big, angry, drunk kitten. And joining Sean tonight is Rosie Jones. Rosie is a lesbian from the north, which means she's got a few fingers and a few pies. Up against them this evening, it's team captain John Richardson. John's got a three-year-old daughter, tiny, needy and whiny. I don't know what his daughter's like. And John's teammate, Tom Allen. Tom Allen looks like an egg, which is probably the reason he loves having soldiers dipped in him.
John's be a fine thing. Don't get the time.
John, you're a fine figure of a man.
Hello.
How do you keep in shape?
Oh, well, you can see. The key thing is not to specify a shape. But I found exercise things you can do around the house whilst eating and going about your daily life, so I now have my knife and fork attached to two dumbbells.
Oh.
So you've got to really be pounding. So my best one is for squat thrusts. What I do there is I've got one of those lavatory seats that lowers gradually, so I start pissing and I just knock it down, and then I've got to just lower with the... Oh, still going!
Oh. Well, that must be a disaster when you're out of your house with your fancy lowering very slowly toilet seat. It's just a regular one and you get yourself in the dick. That's... Tom, your yes, love life, what's the latest?
Well, it's not great. I did go on a date with a Frenchman.
Nothing happened?
Nothing happened.
Why did nothing happen? You're an attractive man, you're on the TV.
Because Brexit means Brexit, Jimmy.
Yeah. That's why, Jimmy.
They have their chance. That tunnel is closed.
Well...
Okay, are you good at taking criticism?
No, I'm not, and I've been doing boxing lessons recently, actually.
You can tell. Tom, you can tell. It's so obvious.
You can tell,
really affected everything.
Thank you. A lot of people say that. It's very good for your core strength. Yeah. I feel like I can handle myself now.
Rosie Jones, do you think you could take him?
Yeah. Also, I'll just go for it, and at least one of them might hit him.
Do you think Sean will make a good teammate?
Yeah. I really like you, Sean.
Oh, thank you.
I think we'll make a great team.
I think we'll do all right.
We should do everything together. Because we're so alike. We're so upbeat and positive. Chuckle brothers.
Yeah. To you.
We'll work on it.
Okay. Sean, if you could go back in time, where would you go?
I think I'd go back to like a minute before I met my wife. I'd wet myself so that she wouldn't want to talk to me. And then a lot of pain and misery would have been saved from the world. No, of course, I'm only joking. It's a comedy show, isn't it? A lot of people gasping like it's sort of... it's you know, Desert Island Discs, and someone in the middle of Desert Island Discs said, my main thing is I really wish I'd never met my wife. If you were asking on a serious front, Where would I go back to in time? I'd like to go back to Germany, 1933, mm-hmm. and try to persuade Hitler to have a different moustache. To get more of a magnum one. And I think he'd be more of a lover than a fighter. Controversial, I know.
I think they'll probably keep the wife one in.
Okay, Rosie, have you got a mascot? Something
yes,
for good luck?
Yes, I do. Something that won't help me cheat. It's a laptop. And I try to take off spell check, but I couldn't. Basically, I can't write, so if you'd stop me using a laptop, I'll sue you.
OK. John, have you got a mascot?
We all love Countdown, right?
Of course. Well, why was I the only one who said yes? Yeah.
But sometimes it can be a little bit of a buzzkill, a little bit of an atmosphere killer. What else do we love? Association football. And what's football got? No anagrams, but they're all very angry, aren't they? And that's what we need, a bit of spunk in the room, don't. We need a little bit of energy. So I've brought some football chants into the sort of Countdown arena. I thought it'd be more fun. I've got one for you, Jimmy.
Oh, yeah, sure.
It's to the tune of Walking in a Winter Wonderland.
Well, I'm liking this already.
There's only one Jimmy Carr. One Jimmy Carr. His teeth are not real. He laughs like a seal. Walking in a Jimmy Wonderland.
Hey, hey!
I love it.
And my favourite football chant of all time is one that Leeds United commit to at every goal kick, without fail, is as the keeper moves to run up and deliver the ball, the crowd will chant, "Oh, you shit bastard!" Ah! So I thought, to build the tension for you, Rachel, as you reach for a letter, I've changed "you shit bastard," obviously, because you nailed the job, to be honest. So, it's a little bit more tense. It's a, "Oh, you picked that one!"
We're doing that for every letter?
Every letter throughout the show. And one thing that I think we can all agree has improved sport and has certainly improved football is the video assistant referee. So to help you, really, there's a lot of, as far as I'm concerned, breaking of the rules at this, and sometimes you don't spot it because you're doing what you do out there. So I've brought in this, which is the video assistant Jimmy, or Vag. I'm going to be your Vag tonight.
Sure.
If at some point something happens that we feel might be an incrimination, then you can say, "Get your Vag out."
to you.
Turn to the screen and we'll review some of the footage and hopefully we can really take some of the fun out of this.
John's Vag, everyone. Tom, have you got a mascot?
Well, interesting story, actually, Jimmy. I had an experience recently where I found out that a Turkish clinic was using my image to advertise its own hair transplant surgery.
And were you before or after image?
Well, I was actually both, as you will see when
turn it upside down.
No, John.
You do. You make most of your money modelling for Guess Who, yes?
Yes, I do. And anyway, so I was alerted to this Turkish clinic that was using my image.
Oh my God! You look fantastic with hair.
Thank you. But I thought it was a ridiculous thing to try and use me for that because obviously I'm very proud of my shiny ping pong head, and I would never even consider getting a hair transplant. And why would I need to? Because I've actually got my collection of lucky wigs. And I brought some of them along tonight. Would you like to see them?
I would love to see you.
Okay,
yes,
fine.
Sure.
Well, I've got a few. This first one, which is my... I wear this if I need to be my own manager, because this is my Kris Jenner momager wig, which I love a lot. I like that one a lot.
You
I
don't know how hair works, do you? Can't
no.
Sort it out. Pushing it every which way.
It's been a long
it's,
time.
It's that way. It's towards John.
Listen, yes. All right, you guys with your hair.
It's been a while.
Show it off of me.
Oh, there you go.
There you go. There oh. you go. You see, now
I'm
I look like
the
Kris
monitor.
Jenner.
You can see how pretty you look.
Well, I don't want to arouse myself. And this one is, if I'm going... Because, you know, I still live with my parents. And if yes. I'm looking for a new place to buy, because I do look at places, then I wear this one, which is my Kirsty Allsop. People don't mess around when you go in dressed as Kirsty Allsop.
No.
Recently, I was described as looking like Kirsty Allsop trapped inside Phil Spencer. I've got one last one, which I like to wear just on special occasions when I'm getting ready for this. And this one is, of course, my Jimmy car. I like to put on to get ready for a countdown, and I put it on, and then I've taken it off quite quickly, because if I leave it on for too long, then the Inland Revenue come knocking at my door.
Good one. Yeah, I like it.
Not as swooped as yours. I'm proud of it.
Okay, Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I have. I don't. You probably noticed. I don't know if you're aware of about the similarities in my career path and Phoebe Waller-Bridge. We both share quite a lot of, you know. I don't have quite as many Emmys or BAFTAs as she does. I don't have a big Amazon, you know, TV deal. But you know, I have. She was asked to spice up the James Bond film.
Yeah.
I've been asked to do the same with the Carry On franchise. They've asked me to make it a bit more gritty, a bit more realistic, give it an edge, you know, and I agreed to do it, you know, and I was wondering if, you know, everyone here would like to help me. I've got some scripts here.
Not
the
half.
Thing I want to point out is, like the old Carry On films, they were quite full of innuendo. This is very witty, very smart, you know, political stuff. I've got scripts for everyone here. There's one for Rosie.
So this is not a Carry On remake. This is a reboot of the franchise.
Basically, I've decided to do a Carry On film about Brexit. It's called Carry On Brexit. And it's really, it might get a bit heavy in places. Mm. It might get a bit like, oh God, this is quite heavy.
So I think, Carry On Brexit, everyone.
Yeah. Okay. So I start. Oh, so do you think we're going to leave Europe?
Well, by looking at the size of your poll, I think we could be in or out.
I think it's sad, because we used to be a member state.
I'll tell you what is sad, the state of his member.
Oh, look at the size of those melons.
You don't get many of them to the pound or kilo.
See? See where it's different? See what I've done? Very clever, isn't it?
Do you think we should have a withdrawal agreement?
I don't think we'll need one. In your case, I think it'll all be over in a couple of minutes.
Very good. I'd just like to direct a bit of direction there.
Oh,
I think,
sorry.
Tom, you're really good.
Thank you.
John, you're dog shit.
I'll go Kenneth Williams.
Awesome. Oh, well, no.
That's not in the script, John.
No,
that's not in the script.
Yeah.
I grant you, the EU does have its knockers.
You've got it.
Right, OK, I'm in it now.
You're telling me you've been to Saint-Tropez?
I want us to leave because I don't like the French.
Not what I've heard. You love a bit of French and Greek. And anal.
See, look. It's a hit.
People love it, Sean. People love it.
It is, isn't it? Thank you. Thank you.
What do you think of the single market?
Full of singles? All that crumpet? Mind if I do? I'm going to act and direct, you know, and write.
Very good, Sean.
Yes, thank you. Anyway, this is the clinching thing. I think the Leave vote was caused by multiple factors. The disillusionment in the mainstream politics, which has failed to engage the general population, coupled with the deprivations of austerity, led to a perfect storm of negativity which found an outlet in the referendum. She's got nice tits.
Fantastic. OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's legendary actor Sean Bean.
Bastards.
Are they friends of yours?
Sean Bean has no friends. Only enemies he is yet to puncture.
OK, for anyone who might be, I don't know, living in a cave, who is Sean Bean?
Well, for a start, he's someone who lives in a cave. But he's also the most successful actor ever to appear in nobody's favourite film.
Have you won any awards?
I have indeed. I recently won TV Quick's number one guy your nan wants to bang. Bastards.
And with Sean Bean, of course, it's Susie Dent! Yay! Susie, do you swear a lot?
Yeah, I am swearing a lot more these days. I don't think as you get older you do swear. I don't know how old you are, Sean, but...
Bastard.
You do... you do... It definitely picks up. There's just so much research going on about swearing now. And one of the experiments they do is making someone put their fist in a vat of ice-cold water and seeing how long they can keep it in for. And if you're saying bollocks really loudly, you can keep it in for 40 seconds longer.
So if you're shouting bollocks, you can keep it in longer?
Yeah. That is the gist of it.
You can hear when you say it, right? How these things sound.
But 2 seconds too late, always.
OK. And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley! Any unusual experiences this week?
Well, it's nice as the pregnancy goes on, you experience different things. So, like, 4 months, the baby starts moving. 7 months, the baby starts getting hiccups. And at 8 months, the baby starts getting hiccups and I can only feel them with my vag.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Chess Set. I genuinely find it a bit creepy when they're fully clothed. OK, let's play Countdown, everyone. Time for our first game. Sean, Rosie, you get the first pick of letters.
Would you like to choose?
Yeah! Yeah. Continent.
Thank you, Rosie. T.
Another.
R.
Another.
F.
Vowel.
I.
Vowel.
U.
She heard you.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
D.
Consonant.
L.
I would advise you, Rosie, to touch Sean a little bit more. He's clearly very much enjoying it.
I'm very comfortable with it.
No, well, good, because there's more. There's more in store, I feel.
What should our last one
be? I don't know. You're so good at choosing.
Okay. I can't turn it.
The last one, V.
Okay, time for the first clock. Your 30 seconds starts now. Go. At RADA.
I haven't seen Benedict Cumberbatch for a while.
Tom, how many?
Six.
J.
John, how many?
Seven.
Sean, how many?
Seven.
Rosie.
Why?
Hang on a second.
Are you just doing an Ocado order?
Is that a word?
No, but if you put what you were going to put there.
Seven.
Well, yeah, of course you're going to high five because he helped you.
Yeah. No, genuinely, we've got the same word.
Yeah.
But we've got it separately.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So, Tom, what is your six?
Refute.
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 Hell of a word.
Tom, you need two E's.
Is there not two E's there?
No.
Rosie, you're seven?
Fruited.
Fruited. And Sean, you got the same?
Yeah.
Bit well, suspect, isn't it?
No. Same person. Yeah.
Peas in a pod.
I got two dreams in life. One to play Countdown and one to be best friends for Sean.
Well, one of those is coming true tonight. OK, John?
Well, I'm tempted, if they've said fruited, to say trifled.
Mm.
Oh.
7 points for both teams. OK, on to our first numbers round. John, Tom, your turn to pick the numbers.
Can I have one big one and five little ones?
One big, five little. And they are 4, 4, 3, 9, 2 and 50. And the target, 705.
OK, and your time starts now. OK, the target was 705. John, did you get it?
Yes.
Did you?
I did, and I caught myself on the camera having a drink, which I think is a real dick move.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to just check if that's actually what happened on the vag.
Here we go. What a wanker.
OK, Tom, did you get it?
No, I got 755, 50 out. That's rubbish, isn't it?
There's a 50 up there, mate. Take that off.
I know, I'd already used that, John. I used up everything.
Sean, did you get it?
Yes.
Rosie, did you get it?
I got 704.
704, one there. Sean, how did you do it?
If you times 50 by 2...
100.
3 plus 4 equals...
7.
Times that by 100...
700.
Then get the 9.
Yeah.
And like knock 4 off it.
For the 5.
Yeah.
10 points to Sean.
Four. Yes, I did it the same way.
You did it the same way.
Yes.
Okay, lovely. 10 points to both teams. Okay, so both teams have 17. Time now to go across Victory Corner. Sean Bean, what have you got for us?
Oh, I've got me, my friend. Live and unleashed. An actor who Steven Spielberg once called to spay his cat.
I've got to say, you're looking very fit at the moment. What do you eat?
Gravel. fossils. Shingles, both the pebble and the disease. It's not easy staying in shape when you're built like a rhombus. Oh, there's a hand raised up there at the back.
Sean, you're massive. Talk us through it.
Great question. I work out. I work in. I've got things going on underneath this pelt that would seriously make you stand up and punch the person next to you. I've now got so big, elephants wash me.
Acting-wise, have you been in anything good recently?
I have, actually, yeah. I recently got killed on this lovely little thriller about Mexican farmers undergoing reconstructive surgery without general anaesthetic.
What's it called?
Going local, down in Acapulco.
Sean Bean, everyone. And here is your teaser. The words are, I dry nuts. The clue is, it's hard work. That's I dry nuts, it's hard work. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease, the words were eye dry nuts. The clue was it's hard work. It was, of course, industry. OK, so both teams have 17 points. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for John and Rosie.
Right! Come on!
John, your turn to choose the letters.
Okey-dokey. Could I have a consonant, please?
H.
And a vowel, please.
O.
Consonant, please.
Oh, no.
I completely forgot we're supposed to be having some hilarious games when you reach for a letter. I'll pick a vowel because it's further away. Vowel, please. Oh! Consonant, please. Oh! Vowel, please. Oh! Consonant, please. Oh! Consonant, please. Oh! And a final consonant, please.
Okay, and your time starts now.
Lovely.
Wow! Oh, hang on. It's like an actual walking ball bat.
Oh. Oh.
Oh,
little one. They are good clones.
Is it a dog or a cat?
Jimmy!
Hello, who likes an ear rub? Who likes an ear rub? You like an ear rub, don't you? Yeah, you like an ear rub.
Jimmy, I've never seen you relate to anything.
It looks so much like my shaved ball bag, it's unbelievable.
Always lands on his feet.
Okay. Oh. What do you think of your clones?
I love my clones. I feel like some are taller than me.
Should we stand you at the end?
Yes.
OK. It looks like a police lineup where they all did it. That's the twist. What do you think of sexy Tom Allen?
Yeah, I do quite like sexy Tom Allen. Yeah, I'd like to have... You've got abs and everything, or are they boobs?
They're abs.
They're abs. Let's have a look. Wow! Me too. OK.
Sorry, are we chatting on Grindr, or... are we still making a show?
I'm very narcissistic. I've got a type. It's me.
Tom's phones, everyone! Back in the fishing. Back in the machine.
Back in the machine. I'll see you later. Thank you very much, me. Thank you, me. Thank you, me. Thank you.
Well, that cat was amazing, wasn't it?
It's a disgusting animal, isn't it? It's repulsive. Actually, I've never seen an animal that makes me feel seasick.
OK, John, what do you got?
I've got a 6.
OK. Rosie?
5.
You got a 5. OK, what's your 5?
Corny.
Very good. Good word. OK. Yeah. Are your 6, John?
Corona.
Corona, can he have corona?
In the astronomical sense.
It's this thing, they're like the halo you get around the sun during an eclipse.
Yes.
OK, 6 points to John.
Well done, John.
OK, Sean Bean, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
Could have gone one better. Right. 7. Cardoon.
Cardoon is a European kind of thistle-like plant, but some of them are edible, a bit like the globe artichoke.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Rosie have 17, John and Tom have 23.
Wow. You're amazing.
Right. Time now for Sean and Tom to go head-to-head. Sean, your turn to pick the numbers.
Oh, no.
OK, my turn to choose. I'd have the Shawnee special, please,
Shawnee special.
Rachel.
4 little ones are 7, 4, 3, 9, and the big ones, 50 and 100. And the target, 652.
OK, and your time starts now.
Thank
the badge.
You want to get your badge out?
Yeah.
Yeah? I can have a look at something for you, Jimmy. What do you think?
Well, during that numbers round,
what do you think you've seen?
I think we had a small pitch invasion.
Oh, there he is. Got a good old close up on his balls. Did you see what he had written on him there?
Couldn't make it out.
Looked like it says, Sack Jimmy.
Oh, no, Jimmy.
Controversial.
Sack Jimmy, he's even given his ball bag a nickname.
Yeah.
So, the target was 652. Tom, did you get it?
No, I was distracted by somebody waggling their junk in my face.
Sorry about that, I just love the numbers.
What did you get, Tom?
I got 687.
Wow, OK, pretty far out.
All right!
Sean?
Did you get it? Yeah, I got it.
How did you get it?
7 times 100.
700.
Minus 50. 3 plus 4 is 7. Take it away from the 9.
For 2.
And then add it, and then you got
it. Marvellous.
OK, so John and Tom have 23, and Sean and Rosie have 27. Time now to go across to Dictionary Corner once again. Sean, what on earth are you doing?
Just pouring me out some trumpet spit. It gathers in the shaft whenever they blow. I drink it and it gives me my mellifluous tones. Lady Dent, can I tempt you with some musical jizz?
No, thanks.
Fair enough. Bastards.
Do you play an instrument yourself?
I do indeed. Permission to demonstrate.
Please.
Gratitude. Sean stands. John, son of Richard, join me.
Oh, John.
Bollocks.
Chair.
Nice.
Oh, this does not look good for you.
Just the one chair.
Come on. You may mount me. Sad, sad ladies. I like it.
Yeah.
This is my mouth organ.
I'm so relieved.
I'm going to teach you how to play it.
OK, this is getting good.
Before I carry on, though, I would actually like to compliment you on the temperature of your anus up here this evening. That's an unexpected addition to the sketch, I must say. Most welcome. You got one hell of a south mouth down there, my friend, let me tell you. I'll have to start calling you Vesuvius. Oh, yeah. I'm telling you. But I digress.
Mm.
Only a bastard would try and play this mechanical breath banjo without practicing first. And as such, I've taken the liberty of creating you a trainee version with stabilisers. Regard, the quad moniker. 3 things you need to play this, my friend. Hands, one either side. Good. Lips, checkity check. And third, the most important of all, air. But the right kind of air from the right part of your body. And that's what I'm going to teach you how to harness here tonight. So, manoeuvre the quad about 1/2 inch from those luscious skeletal lips of yours.
What have you done with those fingers?
You met that cat before, did you? Now, lift up your elbows and get it nice and secure, all right? And that's important, my friend, because I'm going to reach under here, lift up your shirt, and blow raspberries on your belly.
Toddler.
There's a scientific aspect involved in this, that if I manage to hit the right pocket of air, it'll travel up your body, out your mouth, and it'll power the quad moniker, all right? And when it does, you lot better give him a round of applause, because let me tell you something, this isn't an easy sketch to do for anybody, all right? Let's look at what I'm playing with here. I'll do us both a favour. Ha ha! to say, there's not as much vegetation as the heat emanating from the south would have suggested. You all right? You're all set?
I'm having a lovely day.
Yeah. I've got to tell you, boy, I'm going to play you like a bagpipe.
Oh, God.
You ready to go?
Yeah, the sooner we start, the sooner it ends.
3, 2, 1, let's go. Copy your bastards! You did well, my friend. That is some tune you got coming out of there. Hey, give him a round of applause, eh?
Let's do it. Sean Bean, everyone.
Where were you in your fucking boxing lessons when that was going on?
I was enjoying it too much.
How red are we in the tummy tummy?
Oh, we're red.
Let's have a little look.
Pretty
tummy,
red,
tummy.
Jimmy.
Oh. Thank you.
Bites. Lovely.
Thank you.
That's going to be real tough to explain away to the missus.
Do you know Sean B? Well, see you in court.
Good luck suing me. I'm fictional.
Okay, the scores at the moment, John and Tom are on 23, Sean and Rosie are in the lead with 27. And here is your teaser. The words are lick shit, and the clue is it'll make you smile. That's lick shit, it'll make you smile. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were lick shit. The clue was it'll make you smile. It was, of course, ticklish. OK, another letters game, and it's time to ramp up the tension. It's time for the tension round. In this game, we're playing for double points, so the pressure's on. Rosie, this is your first time playing in the tension round.
Yeah.
Do you feel pressure?
I'm absolutely shitting it. And I can't control my shit.
John, you like the tension round, right? Traditionally, the tension round, your favourite round.
The thing about the tension round...
Oh, shit!
What? Have I not suffered enough?
Sean, Rosie, pick the letters.
Yes.
OK.
This is the double points.
Vowel.
Continent.
E.
Vowel.
A.
Continent.
N.
Vowel.
U.
Continent.
C.
Continent.
T. Or W.
Consonant.
And
well, I can see two fun words up there. OK. For double points, it's the tension round. Your time starts...
Oh, fuck off.
Now!
Oh, shit!
Oh, just fuck off.
It's like a lovely wedding. Just... Right.
I'm so tired.
John, would you like a hug?
I would like for you to eat a big bowl of shit.
Tom, how many?
5.
John, how many?
4. And I bet you can guess what it is, Tom.
I hope you can, because I'm going to say it loud.
Rosie.
For the other one.
And, Sean.
Five.
Five, OK. Rosie, you're four.
Twat.
John, your four-letter word.
Unit.
Sean, you're five.
Twice.
Tom, you're five.
Twine. Mm-hmm. T-W-I-N-E.
Well, double points, so 10 points to both teams. OK, Sean Bean, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
They could indeed. Lady Dent, take this one.
Tunicate. Is there for eight, which is a marine invertebrate of a group that includes the sea squirts.
Beg your pardon.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Rosie are in the lead with 37. And here is your final teaser. The words are knobs goo, and the clue is, sounds good to me. That's knobs goo, sounds good to me. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were knobs goo. The clue was sounds good to me. It was, of course, songbook. OK, time for our final letters game. John, Tom, your turn to choose.
Oh, what should we have?
Consonant, vowel, consonant, consonant.
Yep.
L-E-S-R.
Consonant.
M.
Vowel, consonant, vowel.
O.
Thank you.
X. I.
And a consonant, please.
And the last
one.
We
can discard the X.
S.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now. There you go, I'm a spider. Hi.
You got more legs.
God, it's a pain. Okay, John, how many?
Let's try a seven.
Tom.
Five.
Rosie, how many?
Six.
Sean, how many?
Six.
Okay. Tom, you're five?
Roses.
Sean, you're six.
Lesson.
Oh.
Lesson, okay. Rosie, you're six?
Snores.
Oh, that's good.
John, you're seven.
I think I've spelt this wrong. Lesions.
Yeah, no, that's a good seven.
Yeah. Lesions. Oh. Lesions. 7 points for John. Sean Bean, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
Yep, there's an eight up there. Ironless.
Oh, shit.
Ironless? Mm. When would you say that?
I stayed in a travel lodge last night.
It was ironless.
Like an ironless meteorite or something. So it's more about the mineral than the...
OK, so Sean and Rosie have 37. Tom and John have 40. OK, fingers on buzzers. It's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. Hang on. Hang on. Your time starts now. John.
Trombones.
Let's have a look. Oh! He's only got his own. So the final scores are Sean and Rosie have 37, John and Tom have 50. So congratulations, John and Tom. You're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Chess Set. Thanks to all of our fans, our wonderful studio audience, and all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Jimmy's back, hopefully with just two legs, because that spider thing is genuinely upsetting. That's tomorrow night at 9. And just before that at 8, Richard Ayoade immaculately unimpressed by some of the finest cultural hotspots of the globe. But next tonight, Gordon Ramsay's Against the Clock and failing culinary standards.